We begin tonight with breaking news. President-elect Joe Biden formally announcing he is nominating Rhode Island Governor Gina Raimondo to serve as his Commerce Secretary. Good evening. I'm Shannon Heggie.
I'm Mike Montecalvo. We told you earlier this evening when Target 12 politics editor Ted Nesi confirmed Governor Raimondo had accepted the position. The news comes after months of speculation that the governor would join his team in some capacity, first being floated as a possible vice presidential pick, than as a potential Treasury or Health Secretary.
12 News reporter Kim Kalunian's been repeatedly pressing the governor about joining the Biden cabinet. She joins us now with the latest. Kim?
Well, Shannon and Mike, the governor at first downplayed the idea of her joining the Biden team and more recently told 12 News that she didn't have any more to say on the topic, reiterating repeatedly that her focus was on her job as governor. But now we know she is set to depart for Washington, and our political analyst says having a Rhode Islander in the presidential cabinet can't be a bad thing for the Ocean State.
I do.
Governor Gina Raimondo is poised to head to Washington as the nation's next Commerce Secretary. In an announcement of her nomination Thursday night, the Biden-Harris transition team calling her a, quote, champion of creative, forward-thinking economic initiatives. Just a short time later, Raimondo tweeting, Rhode Island may be small, but our economy is mighty on the strength of our small businesses and innovative technologies. As Secretary of Commerce, I will harness that same American ingenuity to create good-paying union jobs and build our economy back better than ever before.
Moving up to a cabinet level position is a great feat for her, and it's also a great feat for the state of Rhode Island.
12 News political analyst Joe Fleming says it's the first time a Rhode Island governor has departed early in over half a century. In her new role, Raimondo will be responsible for promoting economic development and oversight of government agencies like the U.S. Census Bureau. Raimondo is set to join the president and vice president-elect in a news conference from Delaware on Friday. Meanwhile, Fleming says Raimondo's departure for D.C. will shake up the political scene here at home. Lieutenant Governor Dan McKee will assume the governor's role once Raimondo is confirmed sometime after January 20th, and McKee will appoint a new lieutenant governor. Some of the names being floated include Johnston Mayor Joseph Policina, former Central Falls Mayor James Diosa, and State Senator Lou DePalma. But Fleming says it is possible McKee goes outside the box and picks someone from the business community.
Well, there's a lot of good names that have been mentioned. And again, in Rhode Island, anything could happen. You never know what they're going to do.
Fleming says Raimondo's departure will also reposition McKee in the next governor's race.
It's going to put him in a lot stronger position with 2022 because he was wanting to run for governor. And now being the acting governor, it's going to make it a lot easier for him to raise money, which has always been one of Dan McKee's weaknesses.
If McKee runs two successful campaigns, he could be governor of Rhode Island until the year 2030.
Now, Raimondo's news conference alongside the president-elect is slated to happen at 1:30 tomorrow, and it will be live-streamed. But because of the timing of that, the governor will not be at tomorrow's previously scheduled coronavirus press briefing, which will instead be led by the Department of Health at 3 o'clock. Now, we did reach out to Lieutenant Governor Dan McKee's team tonight, but so far have received no comment. Live in studio, I'm Kim Kalunian, 12 News.